Did I get one chorus? Okay. That was, yeah, so fresh, so clean by Outkast.
Yeah. Awesome. First of all, happy Veterans Day. If you're a veteran in the crowd, thank you for your service. So when I moved to Pittsburgh, I was super psyched about my apartment. It was really cheap, it was really big, it's like one block away from a bus stop. But as I continued to live in it, I realized there were some things that made me feel like maybe I wasn't getting the value that I had originally hoped for. The radiators are really loud and they go off at all hours of the night. The concrete walls prevent the Wi-Fi from getting into my room. And every time I encounter one of those things, it hurts. Just hurts me physically, just a little bit. Now, Temper, in a lot of ways, is not at all like my apartment. I have flex leadership muscles that I didn't even know I had. I have made relationships that I know are going to last me forever. And I see first years and second years from all over busting their butts to make this place better than they found it. But in certain ways, Temper is a little bit like my apartment, in that I think we all have had the experience of expecting something and kind of coming up with a reality that didn't, that there was a little bit of a gap there. So my goal as GBA president would be to kind of eliminate that pain by closing as many of those gaps as possible. Some of them are really small. They're keeping the floors clean, they're figuring out how to play nice with the young grads, but some of them are big, like figuring out why there are only two African-American women in our class of 236. Like figuring out how to get those really brilliant researchers that we have here prepared to teach next year's first years in our core classes. So what makes a good GBA president, in my opinion, is three things. One is it's a strong, active listener. Two, it's being able to prioritize, figuring out what will have the most impact for the most people. And three is figuring out how to leverage your resources. I think you should vote for me for GBA president because I have experience doing all three of those things. In my undergrad, I was elected president of my fraternity, so I do have experience being a president. I was in charge of 50 young men in an actual physical house, which was a blast, and I learned a lot about prioritization. While I was at Chipotle, I headed the first employee experience research group where I was responsible for doing research about thousands of Chipotle employees, many hundreds of interviews I did myself. And finally, during Chipotle's darkest hour, the E. coli incident that saved the company, I rolled out over 100 projects in a year to help get us back on track. And I did that across different stakeholder groups with different priorities, which is a skill that GBA president needs. So I want to tell you about someone who I used to be very close with who passed away recently. She was kind of a mentor of mine. She gave me my first job. She was the chef at our fraternity, and she made lunch and dinner Sunday through Thursday. And she had a really successful catering business. And I would always ask her, like, why are you here? Like, why do you want to spend your time doing this? Why don't you want to focus on your business? And she would always say, this is an opportunity for me to give back to an organization that I believe in with something I'm good at. And so now I'll ask you for kind of a similar opportunity to let me give back to an organization in doing something I'm good at. Thank you very much.